Tesla is planning a super long-range version of its Model Y electric crossover, according to documents filed with Chinese authorities. While most Tesla deliveries push to 2022, some Tesla customers have been waiting as long as 4 months to receive their cars as the company repeatedly pushes back delivery dates, CNBC reports. The Model Y itself is due for an update, with Tesla planning to give it a refresh that will include a structural battery pack featuring the upcoming 4,680 cells, the same ones that are also bound for planned Cybertruck production. After months of delays, Tesla's Berlin-Brandeburg plant is expected to be on its way to launch in just a matter of weeks. At the same time, it seems Tesla is about to set up yet another Giga press for upcoming Model Y production in Texas. Also, what if we tell you that the Boulder County Sheriff's Office is testing Tesla's use as a patrol vehicle? Before we start, however, let us know in the comments below what do you think about using the Model Y as a patrol vehicle, and make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, subscribe to Technopol, and hit the bell icon for notifications. Tesla is planning a super long-range Model Y electric crossover. The new variant, which has been registered in the new filings alongside existing variants, will have 640 km of driving range according to the NEDC rating that is still used in China, as well as Australia. In reality, this will likely translate to around 550 km real-world driving range, 565 km using US-based EPA ratings and 584 km using the European WLTP cycle, which Tesla also shows on its website. While the documents do not make clear the size of the battery, it does state that it would be a dual motor with a 137 kW motor on the front axle and 184 kW motor on the rear axle. With this combination, a maximum 559 Nm torque would be achievable. In total, Tesla's Shanghai-based arm has registered 5 Model Ys in the 7th New Energy Vehicle catalogue issued by the Chinese Ministry of Industry and Information Technology for 2021. The other 4 consist of the standard range, on sale in Hong Kong, standard range plus, long range and performance. The Model Y is not currently available for sale in some countries, but its launch on the local auto market is expected within months. Estimated delivery time: new orders for base versions of all Tesla cars in the US is now 2022. The long-range version of the Tesla Model Y recently has joined the Model 3 Standard Range Plus, Model S, and Model X with an estimated delivery time for new orders in the US in 2022. The Model Y long range is now expected in January 2022, just like the Model 3 Standard Range Plus. Both the Model S and Model X long-range versions are also expected in 2022. It means that the order backlog for base versions of all Tesla cars in the US is full by the end of 2021. As we are in the middle of August 2021, the order backlog is 4.5 plus months long. Model S and Model X plaid versions ordered today are also expected in 2022, but the customers still have an option to get the Model 3 long range in November and Model 3 and Model Y performance versions in 2021. The Model 3 and Model Y performance is actually available within several weeks, which suggests that Tesla allocated some reserve for those more expensive and higher margin versions. Those were also the cars that haven't experienced repeated price increases earlier this year. Tesla Model S and Model Y customers are suffering months-long delivery delays, report says. Some Tesla customers have been waiting as long as 4 months to receive their cars as the company repeatedly pushes back delivery dates, CNBC reports. CNBC said it spoke to 5 Tesla customers who said they had suffered delivery delays on cars purchased earlier this year. The delays appeared to be affecting a range of Tesla models, including its Model Y and its deluxe $124,000 Model S plaid. 2 customers ordered Model S plaids in January but were still awaiting delivery of their cars. One of the customers was originally told to expect delivery in March, but the date kept getting pushed back and he still hasn't received it. Musician David Crosby tweeted on Tuesday that he ordered a Tesla car 7 months ago and the company has lied to us 4 times about when we would get it. CNBC reported an unnamed Tesla sales employee as saying that delivery staff weren't getting enough information from management to answer questions from customers who were experiencing delays. The employee was reported as saying that staff were fearful of asking for information. They said that another employee resigned after being threatened with dismissal by managers after he broke the chain of command by sending an email directly to CEO Elon Musk asking about the Model S delays. The employee said staff generally understood that parts shortages and difficulties using new manufacturing equipment at Tesla's Fremont factory in California were behind the delays. The delays also appear to be affecting the $40,000 Model Y. CNBC reported a customer is saying that they placed an order in May for a Model Y and was told he would get his car at the latest by July 28. The date then switched to August 10 on his online account, and kept getting pushed later. His expected delivery window was last set at September 4 to September 24. CNBC reported another customer is saying that they texted a Tesla salesperson to ask whether their delivery date would keep getting pushed back, and asked if there were problems with manufacturing. The Tesla salesperson replied in early August that the global chip shortage was causing manufacturing delays. Elon Musk said in April that the global chip shortage was causing insane difficulties for Tesla. The company briefly stopped production of its Model 3 car in February of this year due to parts shortages. Two of Tesla's biggest potential rivals, Rivian and Lucid Motors, have also delayed their debut car models, citing supply chain issues and the impact of the pandemic. Tesla wants to launch Berlin Model Y this October. After months of delays, Tesla's Berlin-Brandeburg plant is expected to be on its way to launch in just a matter of weeks. Tesla CEO Elon Musk indicated a couple of days ago that the automaker expects the plant, the company's first in Europe and second outside the US, to begin producing the Model Y starting this October. Earlier this summer, the CEO lamented that the plant had become mired in bureaucratic hell, as the automaker raced to get the facility ready amid record EV demand in Europe. The Model Y will be the first model the Berlin-Brandenburg plant is expected to produce, and is easily the most important vehicle for the automaker, both now and over the next couple of years. Besides the Fremont, California plant, Tesla currently produces the Model Y in Shanghai, with the Austin, Texas, and Berlin plants being the two next planned locations. The Model Y itself is due for an update, with Tesla planning to give it a refresh that will include a structural battery pack featuring the upcoming 4,680 cells, the same ones that are also bound for planned Cybertruck production. The 4,680 cells, promising greater energy density, lower weight and a longer range, are expected to give the Berlin-made Model Y a range boost, though the extent of that boost is not known at the moment. Tesla said during 2020 Battery Day that it aimed for a range boost of up to 54%, a very significant bump, that could potentially bring the range of the Model Y to between 450 and 500 miles. Of course, there are a large number of factors at play with the implementation of this new tabless battery design, so it's a little early to talk about what increases we could see in the EPA rated here in the States. If production of the Model Y, with the 4,680 cells, starts in Berlin without further delays, we should soon get an idea of the range increases the Model Ys could expect. However, before Model Y buyers in Europe and in the US receive the updated crossovers, buyers in Europe could receive Chinese-built Model Ys in a matter of days. The first ship with Model Ys from Shanghai was reported to be en route to Europe a couple of weeks ago, with the first examples spotted in Europe on car carriers just days ago. Plans to launch Model Y production in Berlin and Austin after Shanghai underscore just how important the Model Y has become to Tesla, and how relatively less important some other models have become. Model S and Model X production had been absent for a large part of this year, but appears to have minimally affected Tesla's profitability over the past two financial quarters. Other upcoming models like the Cybertruck, on the other hand, are not expected to be a significant factor in sales outside the US at all. Tesla's Giga Austin, new Giga Press has arrived. A few days ago, TeslaRT reported that Tesla had received a shipment that consisted of a massive box from IDRA Group. It would only make sense that the contents of the box could be related to a Giga Press, since we know that's what IDRA makes, and we also know that Tesla has already purchased and installed some of these large casting machines. The initial information came from a tweet by Austin Tesla Club. With that said, it's important to note that people first spotted the IDRA crate in the Tesla Gigafactory Austin flyover, which was posted by Jeff Roberts on August 15, 2021. While people were almost certain the boxes contained something related to the Giga Press, there was no way to know for sure. Perhaps it was just parts, or maybe Tesla was ordering something else from IDRA to supplement the machinery it has already purchased. Some speculated that Tesla has something new up its sleeve, and we'll have to wait to learn more. Fast forward to just a day later, and another Austin Tesla factory flyover revealed more IDRA boxes. Reportedly, the boxes contain the parts for another 6,000-ton Giga Press. For those unaware, the IDRA products are massive dies casting machines that Tesla is using to cast large parts for the Model Y. However, the machines don't weigh 6,000 tons, rather, that figure applies to their capability. As you can see from Joe Tegetmeyer's August 16, 2021 flyover, the boxes are clearly marked, and there's also a spot being prepped for another Giga press. You can see that Tesla is now preparing the foundation for the machine's installation. We're very interested to see how these Giga press machines and Tesla's die-casting techniques speed up Model Y production as Giga Texas and Giga Berlin open soon. Boulder County Sheriff's Office is testing out use of Tesla as a patrol vehicle. The Boulder County Sheriff's Office announced that it acquired a Tesla Model Y to test as a police patrol vehicle. It justified that higher sticker price with gas savings resulting in a cheaper total cost of ownership in just 6 to 18 months. Like many other law enforcement agencies, the Boulder County Sheriff's Office is starting to look into electrifying its large fleet of vehicles. Tesla vehicles have become the go-to EV for police departments around the world. Many have started adding Tesla Model 3s to their fleets, like the NYPD most recently, and now, the Model Y is starting to gain momentum. Last year, Fremont Police and the Spokane Police Department both bought Model Ys to use as patrol vehicles. It can be hard for public agencies to justify buying the more expensive vehicles over the more popular Ford SUVs used for police patrol, but patrol vehicles cover so much mileage that gas savings can quickly add up. The Boulder County Sheriff's Office expects to recover its cost within 6 to 18 months. With the average 5-year life of a patrol vehicle, the savings could be massive. They have been working with several other police departments around the US who have previously adopted Tesla vehicles in their fleets, including the Bargesville Police Department in Indiana, the Fremont Police Department in California, and the Westport Police Department in Connecticut. The Boulder County Sheriff's Office also confirmed that it is working directly with Tesla. While some police departments have been buying Tesla vehicles like any other customers, Tesla has been making moves lately to be directly involved in help law enforcement go electric. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe and be sure to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. There are many more future-focused tech videos coming in the near future, so until then stay tuned, and we'll see you in the next video.